thing for another, it's the name of a sensational musical group that keeps turning out hit records. And for another, it's the name of a smash Broadway musical still playing to capacity audiences after a year on Broadway. And you're about to see two reasons why they're packing them in at the 46th Street Theater. Here are Chita Rivera and Gwen Verdon. Welcome them, please.
It's good, isn't it grand? Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it nowadays? You can like the life you're living. You can live the life you like. You can even marry Harry, but mess around with Ike. And that's good, isn't it grand? Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it? But nothing stays. In 50 years or so, it's gonna change, you know. But oh, it's heaven
in a fast car and keep it hot. Hey! Gwen Verdon, Chita Rivera, and Linden. We'll be right back. Let's bring out the stars once again of Chicago, Chita Rivera and Gwen Verdon.
Say one thing.
What?
Now when my kids ask me, did you ever work with
That's great. That reminds me of the band days when some guy take the microphone and just shout two bars and he'd say, I sang with Kay Kaiser. Right.
We get letters saying, we hear you're both mothers, but our mother can't do cartwheels like you can.
That is something. Dancers work under a lot of pain, and it's a tough life. People don't realize that. If we hurt our ankle or something, we can limp around, but you gals have to go on and perform, don't you?
Well, it's very strange. You can always dance. You may limp walking, but you can always dance.
Somehow,
I'm serious.
You don't feel it as much when you're working.
You have to understand the psychology of the dancer.
You're going to now say that we're masochists.
No, but all I can tell you is I study a little dancing. Everybody does when, you know, in order to be in the theater, and the line they always give to you is, it's not working unless it hurts.
It amazes me, I can tell when Bob Fosse has done something.
Yes.
It has a look about it. I can tell when Gower Champion has done something. Isn't that strange?
They have a real style. They really evolve their own way of moving.
Yep.
And the ones who do that, they last forever.
Yes.
Yeah. The ones who can make people look like and think. I guess you have to think like them.
Oh, yes. He always says you have to act your dancing. Jerry Robbins says the same thing.
Sure.
The really good ones say that to you.
They have their own independent style.
Shoe shine and a smile will get you nowhere in the dance field, right?
As somebody finally said on this show, and I've been waiting a lot of years for it the other day, that they hate going back and doing the same thing over and over again, night after night. And you never tire of what you're doing, right? You go out there and it's a fresh outlook.
You want the truth?
Is it fresh every night?
Well, it is, yeah. I mean, much more so than most people think, because an audience is completely different every night, and so you get a different reaction. At times you can say, oh, God, I wish I could go home. And then you can go on the stage, and the audience is wonderful.
Yeah.
And there's a relationship. Yeah, they bring you right up. Because most of the shows we've both done, we've always stayed in them longer than a year.
Oh, yes, 22 months.
Have any of you ever done like a one night?
Oh, yes.
And a bomb? Oh,
I've done it where I feel like I know I'm uncoordinated. I just cannot get myself together.
Oh,
now, to an audience, you don't know that.
I'm talking about a show that lasts one night.
Oh, I did that.
You did?
Yes, I... Oh.
She says it was like that.
I know. I was actually in a play that we did 3 weeks of previews in New York, at which time they were fixing the show, supposedly.
Taking a thing out, putting a thing in?
Well, they kept taking it out, and they never put anything in. So when we opened, which was opening night, it was
bows.
It was 1 hour and 5 minutes, and no intermission, and that was it. So we went home opening night, and that was the end of the play.
What was the name of that play?
Children. They always say never work with children or animals. The first play that I did was with both children and animals, 3 kids and 2 cats. And the next day I went back to the theater to get the 2 cats. I assumed that everyone forgot about them. They took the kids home, not the children.
How about you, Chita? Do you ever do one of those one-night things?
No, because I was lucky enough to do it in California, where they keep them open for 13 weeks. I did something called 1491.
Oh, yes.
Nobody in the world outside of Hal and my mother know that.
1491. The running gag was it was marked down from 1776.
Oh, yeah.
You both play murderesses.
Right. True ladies from the era. Yes.
How about that?
Well, I don't know. How would you...
I've seen the show.
When Gwen shoots her lover at the beginning of the play on matinee days, I have actually heard some women say, shoot him again! Give him another one!
It's been on Saturday matinee, we get women who, I would say the youngest in the audience is 45, but they come in with all the women's lib expressions, right on, and they scream right on. They just love it.
You know, my theory is that Wednesdays and Saturdays, but particularly Wednesdays, the ladies really come to enjoy. I mean, there's absolutely no other reason why they've come out that afternoon. The day could be beautiful, could be sun shining, but they want to see the show. And they've left their husbands home. Or they're at work.
Husbands or babysitters or whatever.
And they're just so free, and they just are the best audiences in the world.
Yeah, I've said this, and I'll repeat it, and it's not because of my studio audience. Women are better audiences than men, generally speaking. Don't you agree?
I think when it's very naughty and risque, which is putting it mildly for our show, I think the ladies are much better. They're a much better audience. However, we have seen men and women in the evening, and I assume they're married, because if the man enjoys Chita too much, I actually watched her punch him like that. A backhand right across the face. And I saw a lady.
I didn't do anything, everybody. I have all my clothes on and everything.
I like it when I see the woman lean over to explain it to her husband. That's what I like. No, I'm kidding.
What I love is when they get that involved in the show, they can say something like, shoot him again. I was on stage in Bells Are Ringing. It was near the end of the show, and it was where the entire story had to come together. I made a phone call, and the wrong person answered was the idea. And I had to figure it out. And the answer was, it's mom. That was the answer. And I was standing on stage thinking about it. I said, and the lady in the third row said, it's mom! It's mom! She wanted me to...
Thought you forgot it.
Have you ever had anybody
give you
a
line?
Yes, in Bajour, Nancy Dussault and I, there was a number called I Can, and I was the gypsy girl. And
I wonder why, Chita.
I forgot my earring. And I am conning her, and she's saying, you can do it, you can really do it. And I'm saying, yeah, I can, and I will, and I must, and I will, and I won't, I keep saying. So the very last course is, I can, and I will, and I must, and I will, and some woman said, you will! I will!
Did you pick it up? Did you
pick
it up?
Well, yes, it was one of those very...
Even now the audience sings all that jazz, but it's done in a rather strange, syncopated way in the show. And they will sing jazz when she's on a hold. It's a tacit bar, and they go, jazz. And then she goes, jazz.
See, so you don't realize how important you are as an audience. You are, without you, we are absolutely nothing. It's half and half.
We have a line. Believe us, without you, we could not have done it.
It's wonderful.